Hello everyone. Looks like I am now live. Welcome to our regular Thursday hangout, which of the last few weeks I've been doing these with Lonnie. Unfortunately, I've not been able to contact Lonnie today. He was due to come on with me, but I've not heard from him. So it looks like you're going to be stuck with just me. I'm just going to check on Messenger quickly and see if he's messaged me back. No, still nothing. I'm going to quickly drop the link in case he suddenly realizes. Because like I said, for the last, now what is it, 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks, so at least two, I've been doing these Thursday ones with Lonnie. But it hasn't worked out today. I'm just going to send in the chat link, and then if he pops in, he pops in. Otherwise, what I thought we'd do is throw it over to you and see what's on your mind, what's going on in the reselling world, take questions, read out your comments. Right, so that's done. Okay, so welcome. We are live, so if you want to communicate with me whilst I'm live, you need to go into the live side chat. I'm just going to say a few hellos. First in today was Margaret Stewart and George Ross. Hi, George. Margaret's just saying that she watched George's latest video. Chelsea is in. Good to see you. Talking about a trouser press. George is selling trouser presses now. Wow. Hi, Stu, man. Andrew, how are you? To Payne, welcome. Gary, good afternoon, Nick, and guests, question mark. Well, as I was just saying, I don't know if you missed it, Lonnie was due to be here, but we've had a lack of communication, so I don't know what's going on there. He might pop up. He hasn't been answering my messages on Messenger, so hopefully he's okay. Hopefully he's just busy, head down, and completely forgotten that we'd arranged this, and he's fine. But not heard back from him, so I don't know what's going on. So yes, say a few more hellos. If you've got any questions or anything you want to talk about, please drop it in there and we'll chat about it. I'm still, as you can see, you may have seen the video, plowing through cassettes. There was a mountain here and a big pile here. I have listed 91 lots so far, probably about 150 cassettes because some are going in little bundles. But I'm pretty sick to death of them already, I'll be honest. And I'm wondering if bundling these may have been a better idea. I don't know. It's a big experiment, really. Ask me in a month or so when they start selling. I've just sold another three to subscribers. I sent out one yesterday to a subscriber. So I've sold more to subscribers, to you guys, than I have on eBay. Since I started listing, I've sold one David Bowie cassette on eBay. And now four cassettes to subscribers. Crazy. Anyway, welcome everyone. Welcome Ken, Pixie Dust Gaming, Pound Girl, Amy, Chris B. Hi, Chris. Derek is in. Lots and lots of people. Let me get down. He's off garage sailing, says Ken. I don't know where he is. Hopefully he'll appear. You never know. George Ross, question: how would you approach videos if you were suddenly told to stop filming in public? It's a very good question. The law about filming in public in the UK is that there are no real restrictions. If you're in a public place, you're free to film. We had an issue at a jumble sale, the one that we met up with you, George, where I was told specifically that they didn't want people filming there. And of course, I'm going to respect that. So we don't film in that jumble sale. But yeah, for boot sale ones, as far as I'm aware and as far as the law states, you're okay to film in a public place. Paul says, question, how's everyone coping with the summer slump? Our sales have been pretty meh. Pretty average, ticking along. We had a nice £400 day not long ago, but we've been averaging out at I don't know, on eBay anyway, about £100 a day. One particular listing is doing well, and I'm going to do a separate video about how to generate sales on multi-quantity listings. I've been experimenting with a little, it's not really a trick, it's just a way of, yeah, generating sales on multi-listing, multi-quantity listings. So I'm going to talk about that in a separate video and see if people have done the same thing. Hi, Nick, loving the clips. Thank you, Gaz. Good to see you. Pixie Dust Gaming. Yeah, had an issue going on about not, was that the one where you weren't able to pay for an item for some reason? I bought a buy it now off that person, but I'm waiting for her to cancel the previous item as it's hanging around in my basket. Yeah, it seemed really odd. I would have contacted eBay and just got them to sort it out. Hi, Kelly. Hi, Kenneth. Oh, hang on, just jumped. Ruthie's117 says, question, I use eBay a lot, but with their fees and PayPal, does that not take a big portion of your profit? It certainly takes a lump out of what you make. eBay is what, 10% on fees, and PayPal is going to, it varies on what sort of level of PayPal you have. But yeah, of course, you have to keep that in mind. But hopefully you're selling stuff with enough profit margin to absorb that. The thing with, nobody likes paying fees, and I've had this discussion before about eBay. eBay charge you 10% on your final value fee. Obviously, there's certain fees involved in listing, whether you're paying a shop subscription or per listing fee. But no matter where you sell, well, apart from Facebook, which is pretty much free, well, it is free. And some of the other apps are free to sell, like Spock and stuff. If you go to a car boot sale, for example, to sell your stuff, you'll pay on average like a £10 pitch fee. And let's say you sell £100 worth of stuff, there's your 10% as well. If you sell on the high street, as we did for many, many years, you pay rent, you pay rates, you pay staff if you have staff. And there's costs of sale. You know, there's costs involved in reaching those customers, if you like. And yeah, some people moan about eBay's fees. I don't think they're extortionate. I think if Facebook ups their game and makes the selling on there a bit more regimented, and you have a bit more cover, you know, and things are set in place, I think eBay would have to look at their fees again, because currently, if you do sell on Facebook, as you know, there are no fees. You sell it, you get paid, end of. But it's a bit like the new Wild West selling on Facebook. There's no rules and regulations in place. Hi, Adrian, how are you? Adrian sent us some gifts. I was going to wait until the Sunday one, but seeing as Adrian is in, Adrian's been a supporter of the channel for a long time. And we randomly received, well, it wasn't random. You did warn me it was coming. I got a sign to put up on the wall in here. I don't know if it's going to go up in here. I might put it up in the kitchen, which has a bottle opener. He knows I like my beer, so thank you for that. And then Andrea got a Disney mug. Like, we need another mug, Adrian. What are you doing to me? So yeah, we were thrilled to receive those. Thank you. You really didn't have to do that. Chelsea says, I expect Lonnie is celebrating American Independence Day. Yes. Is it the 4th today? It is. Is it? I'm so out of touch. I thought it was the 3rd still. Yes, it's Independence Day. Yeah, they're probably out with the family. Real Ale says, Nick, love your videos, but my sales are so slow, just not happening. Well, I'm sorry to hear that. We've been doing this a long time. We do see sales go down when the weather is really good, because like, people's minds are not on going on the internet and buying stuff. Their minds suddenly are on having a barbecue, going to the seaside, going out for a walk, going to the pub, sitting in the garden. You know what I mean? I think people's mentality flips when the weather changes. We certainly used to see that when we had retail outlets. we would say big slumps when the weather was good. So I think that's affecting it. MK says, hi, Nick. My husband, Ren, has been so inspired with your videos. Thank you. That's good to know. Hi, Andrew. Money Mental. Good to see you. Darren says, can you say hi to Juliet? Of course I can. Hi, Juliet. Okay, let me scroll on. Kelly says, question. It's been a few months now. What's your thoughts on Good Till Cancelled? I don't know. I've been hearing that Craigslist Hunter Pete has done some videos where he showed the decline in his sales. And I haven't watched the video yet. I keep meaning to go and do it. But what he's done to kind of counteract that is he's manually cancelling and relisting. And he reckons that's working for him. Because my fear is, if you don't know what we're talking about, if you sell on buy it now, if you list something and you set your price, you used to be able to say, I'm going to list this for 10 days, I'm going to list this for 30 days or 3 days or whatever. You could pick the duration. What eBay have done now is they've stipulated that you have to list it as good till cancelled, which means it's on for 30 days. If it hasn't sold, it automatically relists itself and you are charged again. And it basically stays on forever until it either sells or you choose to cancel it. The fear with that is that your items slowly get lost on eBay in the best match results, in search results. And people have done experiments in the past, and I've talked about this in the past. We used to have all our stuff way back on Good Till Cancelled, all our fixed price stuff. I switched to 10-day listings. This is going back, I don't know, a couple of years, year and a half maybe. And we saw a big rise in our sales because we were getting boosts in best match when you list it because it's a brand new item. And when it was coming to its end every 10 days, we would get another boost and we would see sales spikes. So I might experiment, as Pete Craigslist Hunter has been doing, with manually ending a load of stuff and then relisting it. The thinking behind, and we spoke to Hannah at eBay, the thinking behind this from their point of view is that they want items to be more permanent so that they have a chance to appear on Google searches. It's meant to be much better for SEO, but I'm not sure it's panning out for everyone. So I think I'm going to experiment and take a look at that video that Pete's put out and see exactly how he's been doing it. He reckons it's helped his sales. So, yeah. Metallica fan says, do you like Metallica? I wouldn't say I'm a fan. I do appreciate their music. Yeah. I do like Metallica, but not one of my favorite bands. I'm not really into the heavier stuff. Nothing Else Matters is a song I bought on single. I do love that song. Okay. Do you sell PS1 games on your eBay, says Adam? Yes. I don't think I have anything currently for listed. I did sell a really nice PS1 game about a month back, though. Tombi. Was it Tombi 1 or 2? Tombi 2. And I held out for 110, was it? 120? I don't know. I'm getting old. I can't remember. Derek says no slump here. So Derek's sales haven't slumped, which is good to know. Are you selling the Furby? The red one, no. The red one was a gift from Chris. The others, there's actually two up there, the stripy ones. They will be sold, yeah. If you're interested, drop me a message on Facebook and we can sort something out. Hi, Cares. Well, I'm going to try and catch up in the chat. If you're just joining me, Lonnie was due to be here. We've got a thing going on where this chat is alternating between Lonnie and my channels. But I couldn't get a response from him today. We're thinking maybe he's off celebrating 4th of July. Because, of course, he is in America. Diesel Engine says, strawberry season just started here. I used to pick strawberries. As a teenager, I used to pick strawberries for beer money, basically. and potatoes. Used to go potato picking, follow along behind a tractor, picking up potatoes, putting them in sacks. Happy days. Here's an interesting comment from Bundle by UK. Luke says, when you actually think about the reach and the fact that you will get out what you put in, eBay's fees are ridiculously cheap. Now, you don't hear that said very often. In my opinion, they could quite easily charge more. Interesting. I don't think they're extortionate, as I said before, at 10%. I've been in the business of selling in one form or another most of my working life. And we've done high street retail. And as I've said, the fees involved and the costs involved in high street retail really put things in perspective when you look at eBay's fees. So I come at it from that angle, and I don't think it's too expensive. But I know a lot of people do moan about the fees. Bayron Pena, is that? Is from Honduras. Welcome. Hi, Antoinette, how are you? Right, let's see if we've got any more questions or comments. Pixie Dust Gaming thinks they should go back to giving you the option as to how long you have the items on for instead of taking over. Yeah, it did cause a big stir when they took away that choice from us. But it is early days, yeah. I think a lot of people are, if they are having slow sales, they're just automatically looking to that change and assuming that's what it is. Hi, Thrifty 5050. Nick, your postal system seems quite different from ours in the US. Do you get discounts via eBay for your post, or do you do like a bulk package mailing thing through your post office? I have a Royal Mail, so a post office account, so I do get some level of discount. Yeah, I have an online account and I print off my postage labels at home, so I can work things out by the average weight and I get a certain level of discount. It's not amazing, but I do get discount that way. Yeah, I was chatting with Lonnie about this. In the US, I think it's more complicated because you are such a vast country. You can't send something to Alaska for the same rate as, you know, a state that's right next door to you, right? It's all done on distances, which makes sense. Whereas the UK, the whole of the UK is the size of like Florida. So we have a much simpler system in that sense because it's, you know, a first class letter is the same to get to the top of Scotland as it is to send next door. So that makes things a bit easier. Hang on, chat just jumped. Oh, where was I? Right, A. Armad says, I only started reselling after watching your videos. Wow. So far, so good. Really enjoying going to the boot sales and finding bargains. Love your videos. Keep up the good work. Thank you. That means a lot. Hi, Paul Calvert. How are you? Question, are you using Seller Fulfilled Prime? I noticed you can. Will the buy box? I noticed you can win the buy box even against an FBA seller. I'm not doing Seller Fulfilled Prime. I'm still, we're talking about Amazon now. If you don't understand what that means, how do I explain that? I do FBA. So I send stock up to Amazon and then they fulfill it. So people with Prime benefits can get free next day shipping and all of that stuff. They've rolled out a thing now where I could offer Prime from here. Obviously, I have to ship it and get it to my customer next day, et cetera, and offer all of those benefits. I haven't gone that route. I still do some merchant fulfilled, but I'm not doing it Prime. Yeah. Are you doing it, Paul? It feels like a lot of hassle. I'd rather just send it up. Makes more sense. I am going to be talking with Habu again soon about doing essentially FBA for eBay and sending a load of my stock up to Habu. I know since we did that last video, a few friends of ours have started using Habu to fulfill their orders for eBay. So I think I'm going to do it with the more bulky stuff, with electronics and in a bid to create some space in here, if nothing else. But media and this sort of stuff, I really don't think it makes sense because I can ship this so quickly and easily and cheaply. It makes sense for, you know, like that food mixer, for example, the steering wheel, the bulky stuff that I can just send up there en masse, forget about it, get more space and make this a much more easier place to work in because I fill this up so easily. Half the battle is it's not listed and sold. If I just cleared some of the backlog, it would, you know, achieve the same goal, really. Gary, hi. My thoughts on good till cancelled. Not good if you are in a crowded market. Items without much competition does not really matter. Yeah, I would tend to agree. June was our highest profit month in selling full-time for nearly 4 years. Fantastic. It's interesting. When you do hear resellers talking about slowdown and how terrible things are, there's always somebody with the opposite going on. What that tells you, I don't know. I think perhaps it's more down to individual circumstances than it is the platform. Hi, Veranda Files. Crispy, I've ended a few sticky items in the past week, then relisted and the item is sold. See, that would lean towards my old theory that if you stick something, if you relist something, you get that boost from eBay, who naturally wants to promote a brand new listing and get it in front of people. So I think I'm going to experiment with ending and relisting and see if that helps. Not that our sales are terrible, but they've been better. Pixie Dust Gaming. A few people I know have been complaining that eBay keep putting best offer on their items automatically. What's that all about? I don't know. I've not seen it on mine. I've not had that issue. The only issue I had was with promoted listings that were getting, the rates were being changed. I do put best offer on a lot of my stuff anyway. So if eBay sneakily added it, I'd probably think I did it myself, to be honest. But I enjoy best offer. I'm doing really well out of that. Kelly, question. Oh, here's a good question. How beardy are you going? It's a very good question. I'm at the point where it's getting, yeah, you know, I'm very conscious of it. I've never really gone much beyond this. I don't know. I fancy I might shave off this and just leave like this bit. Would that look bad? I don't know. We shall see. It'll likelihood is it'll just vanish one day because I'll have got fed up with it. Someone else asking, are you selling the Furby? I'm selling any Furby you can see apart from, what did we decide he was called? Was it Tatty? Apart from this one that Chris kindly gave us when we were down at the meetup in Bristol. This one's not for sale, but if you're interested in the other ones, then yeah, drop me a message and we'll sort it out. The Veranda Files. In my garden, the black raspberries, red and black currants, and mulberries especially are ripe. Wow. Sounds awesome. King of Pennies says, Amazon FBA is very expensive, and with that, you have to constantly feed the beast. Yeah, I've been neglecting Amazon recently. I sent up 15 kilos maybe 2 weeks ago of stock, and that's been selling. But I do need to push on and do more. I've got a load of toys and games I need to send up and a bunch more media that you probably can't see up here. I stack up Amazon stuff up there. I'm not sure about Amazon. I was chatting to Tom recently about this. Amazon have done a few things recently that have really wound me up, and it's still a significant part of our business. Otherwise, I think I'd just pull out altogether. And then when I think about it at Christmas, we do incredibly well at Amazon. So I don't know. They're just winding me up. I'm a lot happier with eBay than I am Amazon at the moment. Should we just say that? Tommy Bernard was saying the only reason Pete does the ending listings is because he has very obscure items and he doesn't do promoted listings as he has no competition. Yeah, I think that does make sense if you think about it. If you've got something and you don't have any competition, A, you're not going to want to put promoted on it in the first place. But then would it make sense to end those sort of listings? Because if you have no competition, it doesn't matter where you are in the search result because people are going to find it. So you might as well just leave it on, surely. See what I mean? I need to watch the videos. I need to have a chat with Pete, actually, or maybe ask Pete if he wants to come on and talk to us about it. I interviewed Pete maybe 2 years ago on this channel. Such a cool bloke. We had so much in common. Maybe I'll message Pete and see if he can come on and explain his views on it. That would be great. Hi, Steve. Kelly, I've decided to ZZ top. I ain't touching the chin part until December. So you're growing this bit out. I'm not sure. Mine would be grey. Look, this is just shocking. Maybe I should. Maybe I should just grow a wispy grey beard. Do a Gandalf. Going back to eBay fees, Mark Goddard says, if you can turn £1 purchase into £20 or more, then 10% is nothing. Yeah, if your profit margins are there, the fees don't seem a big problem. If you're operating on slim margins, then yeah, 10% is going to mess things up severely. Anyone else not had their packaging voucher this month? We forgot to use ours last month. So annoyed because I need some envelopes. I haven't seen the new one. So no, I don't think we've had ours yet. Okay. Oh, sorry. Chat has gone. Berserk again. Oh my goodness. How long have I been on? Oh, there's Steve saying, don't shave it, let it grow forever. Oh, I'm not sure that's a good idea. Oh my God, I've missed so much chat. Wow, God. Okay, I'm gonna have to like try and catch up. Oh my goodness. Hold on. I cannot keep up with this chat at all. Right, I was there. Wow. Okay. Oh, hi, Dave. Oh, I need to speak to you, Dave, about sorting out that BBC, sending the power pack to your mate and getting it repaired. Right, let's whiz through and do some questions quick. It's so hot in here. I'm starting to get all sweaty. Sweaty and beardy. How lovely. Okay. Questions. Judgment Care USA says, ouch, I gave away and threw out hundreds of cassettes about 10 years ago. Yeah, they're trendy at the minute. They are selling. Well, I say they're selling. I've listed, how many lots did I say? I'm on lot number 91 and I sold one. So they're not exactly zooming out the door. Bobby says, I worked charity in High Street and I don't know how they operate with rent rates, etc. I agree eBay fees are not too bad when considering the shop approach. Fourth consecutive garage sale trail this weekend, way more sales than last year. Is it catching on and is it going to be as big as in the US? I do hope so, says Ken McMillan. I think it's slowly catching on. We've done just the one so far this year, but there's regular ones now around here that they do it yearly. And we are still talking about it, haven't done it, about setting one up in Hitchin, which is our local town. I think it is growing. Happy Independence Day, Glyn. Okay, let's whiz through. Sorry if I'm missing stuff. I can't keep up. Stephen says, because of you, Nick, my spare room is full of tat. Love your videos. Thank you. Hi, Shelley. How are you? Richard Payne. Right. I ended 70-odd items a few weeks ago after seeing Craigslist Hunter's video and had a few sales within hours of doing selling similar. Worth doing, in my opinion, with one-off items. So again, that was with one-offs. But if they're one-offs, why were these people that were searching it not finding it anyway? Interesting. Reese says, I'm quite wary about sending items to Amazon. Never tried it yet. Is there any guarantee or protection for the items once it arrives in their system? If the item, I've had this a few times, if they break or lose or damage the item whilst it's in their warehouse, you are compensated. But they use a very weird way of valuing, you know, paying out. They value it on recent sales history on the item. In some cases where I've been paid out, I've got a lot more than I expected. In some cases, less. So it has averaged out on things they've lost or damaged. But in a nutshell, yes, you are covered once it gets to the warehouse, yeah. Okay, let's scroll through. Oh, Richard's averaging £196 a day this week. Fantastic. Paul says, yes, Nick, I'm doing it for slow-moving items with a high sales rank because of the fees and long-term storage. Oh, so that's talking about seller fulfilled prime, which we were talking about before. Right, I'm going to whiz through and try and find some questions. Broken English. Have you thought about employing someone to list and research for you? We have had employees in the past, not so much for eBay, but for when we've had retail outlets. We are trying to downsize our business. So employing people, because we work from home, I wouldn't really feel comfortable necessarily having someone at home here. And I'm a control freak. When I have employed people, it's not been easy being a control freak and letting people do stuff that I used to micromanage. It was terrible. Anyway, Josh says, sold my first two items on eBay yesterday. Thanks for your vids. I learned so many tips from you. Thank you. Congratulations. It becomes addictive. Be careful. Bexify says, people aren't always going to want what you're selling. Everyone has quiet periods. This is true. eBay is very much like riding a roller coaster. Vintage Vandal, how much of that stock behind you is listed? Let's have a look. The last couple of bays here have a lot of listed stock on, but not all of it. That end bay is pretty much... A lot of it's listed, some of it isn't. And then there's two bays here that you can't really see that are all... This is where most... That way. These two bays are listed stuff. You may have seen the videos I did picking orders in the morning. That's where I pick most of my stock from. And then all of Andrea's stock, we have an awful lot of clothing listed, and that's all stored in a wall of IKEA boxes in her office. All flowery and lovely. Mine's all industrial and manly. okay, let's see what other questions we've got. We could do like a 15-minute quiz at the end if anyone's into that. I need to blow my nose. Sorry, guys. I like the beard. It suits you. Ooh, that's Catherine. Thank you, Catherine. Okay. Nick is going for a full-on Steve, says Pete. Oh, there we are. That's when Steve said, don't shave it, let it grow forever. I am so far behind, I apologize. I sold a pair of jeans, the tag read, excuse me, the tag read 34 by 30, but the actual measurement was 36 by 30. I stated this in the listing and assured the buyer 36 by 30. I measured three times, buyer filed a complaint. That's annoying. Asked them to return it. Or they're just asking for money off. We've had a few over recent months where people have made a sort of thinly veiled complaint and issue and have asked for money off, and we just don't entertain that anymore. We just say open a case, and a lot of people just drop the issue and go away. There's a lot of fishing for partial refunds goes on eBay. Gary says, leave a goatee, need a beret, roll neck black sweater and a pipe. That's a look I'm not sure I could pull off. Have you ever had any eBay employees buy your items? Not that I'm aware of. Destroy the Furby. I've done that once. That was a one-off charity event. Not likely to be repeated. Okay, let's zoom down. Question, I saw in a previous video you had some whimsical World of Pocket Dragons. Are they selling, as I'm unsure whether to pick them up or not? Good question. I had a message come through. I listed them as one job lot. They are all sitting in here. This is what we're talking about. I listed a job lot of, I think it's 10, and I put them on at £30. I had a message yesterday or the day before. So a collector wanting one specific one. I've listed these at 30. They offered me £7 just for that one. I said, if you make it 10 to cover the shipping, I'll let you. It was one of the larger ones. There's some small ones and larger ones. Because I said, I would rather sell it as a job lot, because if I sell you one, I've got to cancel that listing. And then I've got to redo the pictures, et cetera. And I'd rather it goes a lot. But I sent her an offer on that message at £10 for just the one on the listing of all of them, which was interesting. And it worked out fine. So she messaged me on that listing. I replied to her and said, yes, you can have that one. I've sent you an offer of £10 total to include the shipping on the one figure, which she accepted. So I just sent her the one from that listing of all of them. And now I'm going to relist it and just redo the pictures. But in answer to your question, I don't know if they're really worth picking up. I paid £2 for 10, which I was happy to do. I'll probably relist that lot at 25 now. Okay. Oh, the chat's just jumped again. I don't know where I was. Daisy May. Have you seen Taylor's Trepreneur channel? I can't read that. 0 to 100,000 through flipping items. He is local to you. No, I've not heard of that. How do you research unique items? Been searching for months, but no joy. Some items, well, as you said, if they're unique, you're not going to be able to find much out in the way of sales, so you just have to pick a price you're comfortable with. You can't research everything or find solds for everything. Amazon just lost a case in court about taking responsibility for fake and bad Chinese items, says Kenneth Christensen. Interesting. Okay, let's scroll on. How are we doing for time? Try and answer a few more questions. If you're popping in late, this isn't usually how these Thursday shows go. I was planning on having Lonnie with me. We're assuming he's out doing 4th of July things and he completely forgot. So I'm kind of throwing it over to you and just reading what is on your mind. Do you do everything tracked or signed for? Well, with my Royal Mail account, everything has the 2D barcodes on, at least on parcels. And then we add signed for on some stuff. Oh, it's just jumped again. Have you ever had success with Facebook Marketplace? I know I've just missed a load of chat. I'm not sure I can go back through it now. We're going to end on a little bit of quiz. Have you ever had success with Facebook Marketplace? Just managed to snag 3 Mario Switch games for £10 each. Wow, nice result. Yes, but very limited with Facebook. I have had some good pickups. I've done well, and I shared recently going on to local groups and just saying, I'm looking for packaging supplies. Last time I did that, I got so much bubble wrap and probably about 100 or so, what do you call them, jiffy bags. And I got loads of these as well from a lady who works at the post office. All different sizes of sealable bags. Right, let's get to the end. Now, usually quiz is a Sunday thing. Just trying to get to the end. Question, do you have any liability insurance for selling secondhand electrical goods? I do not. Most people don't. Hi there from Holland. Hi there. This is 65 Angel Fish. The previous question was from Artful Rascal. Hi there from Holland. Question, where do you inform your media prices? Discogs, question marks. No, I do my research on the platform I'm selling on, which is eBay. Or Amazon, if I do sell some media on Amazon. Although they've made that a lot more difficult with restrictions. Hi, Dermot. Hello, Nick. Found a lovely Buzz Lightyear, 20 years old. Nice. In an attic? Okay. King of Penny says, I did that, talking about asking on Facebook for packaging. He says, I did that and loads of people messaged me with packaging, so saved shed loads of money. So thanks for that, Nick. Good. If one person saves some money from that video, then my work is done. Fantastic. Just say no to quizzing. What? You don't want to quiz, Kelly. You don't have to take part. Pixie Dust Gaming says, have you ever thought about doing an auction on here to your viewers of the stock you don't want or can get rid of and then donate to charity? We have thought about it. I know we did the charity auction, and Dwayne, who came on and called the auction for us, he has a regular show. I think it's still going. Oh, so hot. Where he sells off stuff on behalf of other sellers. So maybe we could think about doing that. We could get other resellers on and auction their stuff off as well. Perhaps we should. Okay. I need to wrap this up pretty swift on 7 o'clock. So we've got 15 minutes. Someone else asking for my eBay page. Our eBay store is The Hills Are Alive with dashes in between each word. YouTube live auction. Brilliant. Maybe we should do that. I'm not sure what stuff we would sell off, though. Message me if you want to come on this channel, because we have obviously quite a large reach now, and auction stuff. I'll happily host an auction for someone else. But I'm not really sure, like I say, what I would sell off. I'd be so worried I'd undersell it. Okay, so if you've never joined us on the Sunday live hangout, let's put Tati over there. We often end that with a quiz, so I thought we'd do that now, just for laughs. Shall I do music? Shall I do general knowledge? Can't see my quiz book. Here it is. A few US resellers do that regularly, auctions. Yeah. Mothership Products is the one that I know, Dwayne. He does it regular. Nick, that's the issue with auction. Set a reserve price. You could set a reserve price, but then you might as well just start there. Do you know if it's possible to use Habu fulfillment if you are living in the Netherlands? I think so. Did we cover that? When we had Martin on, I'm not sure if we covered that. I think if you can get the stock to him, to their warehouse, they can fulfill it. It's as simple as that, I think. Give Martin a call or drop him an email. He'll chat with you. Boo, says Kelly. What's up with you, Kelly? We've only got like 10 minutes left anyway. Okay, we're going to do a little bit of quiz just to wrap this up. If you're not into quiz, you don't have to stick around. How this works is I'll ask a question. The first correct answer that appears on my screen, it may be different on your screen, gets a point. Oh, I'm going to have to keep score as well. Here we go. I usually have my glamorous assistant for that. Okay. Are you still in, Kelly? Are you going to play along? How is Andrea going to be judged? I could call her in for a contentious issue. I've just got a super chat from Print Me Up, $9.99. Wow, thank you. That's so kind of you. Please, guys, as sellers, also buy on eBay. It helps with the algorithms, and I don't mean packaging. Please, guys, as sellers, also buy on eBay. It helps with the algorithms. Really? That's interesting. We do buy a lot on eBay, to be fair. Interesting. Thank you so much for the message and the super chat. I'm still here, says Kelly, so it better be easy. You want easy questions? Okay. I know the answer to this. I'm just going to check I'm right. Yep. Here we go. So first correct answer in. For the last 10 minutes, we're just going to mess around and play quiz. In which year? This is a year question. So you're only allowed 1 year. Don't spam me with loads of years. In which year did Euro Disney open? So I want the year that Euro Disney opened. First correct answer gets the point. So when did Euro Disney open? In France, obviously. And we're going there this year. Okay, lots of answers coming in. Let me scroll back. Oh, the second answer was right. It's Dave, 1992. Well done, Dave. Yeah, I need to message you again. Don't let me forget about sorting out this BBC that I managed to fry. Yes, that opened in 1992. And did you know that they really struggled for the first few years? It nearly went bankrupt. It kept on having to be bailed out. I think it's, you know, making lots of money now, but the French didn't even want it there. There's some good videos on that about that on YouTube. Yeah, thanks, mods, for sorting out that. When you put numbers in, for some reason, it holds them for review. Okay. So Dave has got a point. Second question. Who played the title role in Bergerac? We want full name. Okay. I do want surname. I know who this is. Yeah, I was right again. Wow. Hi, Jennifer says, hey, Nick, made it live. So I want first name and second name of who played the title role in Bergerac. Ah, here they come. I can see lots of correct answers. It is John Nettles. Chelsea. Wow. Well done, Ellen. Ellen? Ellen. So Dave and Chelsea, 1 point each. Oh, I think this is easy. It might not be. Well done if you got that right. The answer was John Nettles. Next question. Ooh. Which wartime singer had a hit with We'll Meet Again? First and second name. We all know this, surely. John Stingy Guy. Stu Mandry is straight in there. Yeah, pretty much everyone getting this. It is Vera Lynn or Dame Vera Lynn, as somebody put, but I am accepting Vera Lynn. Who was first? Stu Mandry. Well done, Stu. So we have Dave, Chelsea, and Stu all on one. If you're just coming in, we've done the talking about reselling. We're just, for the last 10 minutes, we're having a quiz. Okay, still on entertainment. Next question. Who put Girls Aloud? It wasn't Girls Aloud. Right, next question. Who had a hit with The Land of Make-Believe? You have to be my sort of age to remember this one. The Land of Make-Believe. Da, 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 da. Wasn't Depeche Mode, Lisa, no. The Farm, Dave? Oh, now everyone's getting it. Yes, 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 yes. Most people have got this right. It was Bucks Fizz. I'm going to check because I haven't actually checked, but I'm sure that's Bucks Fizz. Yep. Bucks Fizz. So who was first? Ooh, Chelsea. We have a leader. Alan is on two. Dermot put Dollar. Yeah, very similar to Bucks Fizz, weren't they? But no, it wasn't Limahl either. He did Never Ending Story. Okay, make sure you're watching live. Click the little red live dot thing so you're not lagging behind. Okay, so let's have another question. I'll stick with entertainment for this one. Okay. Which children's radio program, that dates it, began with these words? Are you sitting comfortably? Then I'll begin. So I want the name of the children's radio program. Began with the words, are you sitting comfortably? Then I'll begin. Not Archers. That's not a kid's one anyway. Blue Peter, no. Play School, no. Now, Cap Boom has put Watch With Mother. It was, as Stu has put, Listen With Mother. I'm just going to check. I haven't even checked. Where's the answer? Yep, Listen With Mother. So I've got to give that to Stu. Oh, there goes your lead, Alan. So we've got Dave on one, Chelsea on two, Stu Mandry on two, and we've got 5 minutes left. Okay, we're going to go science and nature. You've probably got about, this is probably about the three question warning. Ooh. Okay, back to secondary school physics lessons. Which force opposes motion, wastes energy, and produces heat? Which force opposes motion, wastes energy, and produces heat? It's not gravity. It's not kinetic. A lot of people are now getting it. I've just got to scroll back. It is, of course, friction. Just double check. Yep. And the first was trigger them. Right. We have somebody new on the score sheet. Trigger them. Well done if you got that friction. I know the answer to that, I think. Oh, it's a good question. What was the name of the first artificial satellite launched by the Soviet Union in October 1957? What was the name of the first? It says artificial satellite, because it's, you know, a man-made satellite. What's the name of the first satellite launched by the Soviet Union in October 1957? Surely we know this. Oh, here they come. Wow. Yes. So many people know this. Got to scroll back. Who was first? Oh, so close, Alan. You were one behind. Trigger them. Three-way tie at the top. The answer was, of course, Sputnik. Who remembers the band Sieg Sieg Sputnik? Must have been like mid-80s. Like some cyberpunk crazy band. Okay, so now we've got probably time for a couple of questions more, I'd imagine. We've got Dave on one, Chelsea, Stu Mandry, and Trigger Them all on two. So well done if you got Sputnik. Yes, Mad Hair. Exactly, Catherine. Did they do, like, was it Love Missile? Something like that. I can't remember. Oh, I have no idea. I would guess at something. Oh, I would have guessed right. But then I would say that. The core of the Earth is made of nickel and which other element? So we want the name of an element. The core of the Earth is made of nickel and which other element? Beg your pardon, Kelly. Love Missiles, eh? A lot of people getting this right. The element, as well as, what was the one that was in there? Nickel. The other one is iron, and it's John Clissold. Well done, John. So we still have a three-way tie at the top between Chelsea, Stu Mandry, and Trigger Them. We'll keep going. We might have to have a tiebreaker. But I think this is going to have to be the last regular question. Let's go over to general knowledge. Well done if you got that. That was iron. Super Leeds is saying I was first again. I know I've done this before, but I'll quickly share because I know it's frustrating. I'll show you what I see. And I'll leave this up. Okay, so that's what I see. So you can see that John was first, followed by Stu, and Super Leeds is there. So I'm sorry if on your screen you were first, but it's some technical thing. Dave will explain, won't you, Dave? Right, I'll leave that up. You can say hello, Mum, now. General knowledge. So this is the last regular question. So if Chelsea, Stu Mandry, or Trigger Them get this, then it's over. If not, we're going to do a tiebreak question. Wow, let's pick a good one. Okay, we're going to go simple. What is the capital of Austria? This could be for the win if Chelsea, Stu Mandry, or Trigger Them gets it. I don't know what it is. I'm having to look. Okay. Oh, I can see lots of correct answers. Okay. Scrolling back. The correct answer is Vienna. And hey, Alan has won. There it is. Just a fraction before John Clissold. Oh, that would have made it a four-way tie, John. That was close. So well done, Alan. Is that the first quiz you've won? Fantastic. So we give away tap points for our quizzes. Highly valuable and sought after. So Dave gets one tap point, Chelsea gets 3 for his correct answers and the bonus 5 for winning. Stu Mandry and Trigger Them get 2 each, and John Clissold gets 1. And I am going to have to love you and leave you. So I need to go and have my dinner before going out to play cards with friends in the pub. So I hope you enjoyed that. I'm sorry Lonnie wasn't able to be with us. I'm not sure what the plan is moving forward, whether we're going to keep alternating these Thursday hangouts between this channel and Lonnie's channel. I'll have to get in touch with him and find out. But I will be back on Sunday with Andrea, no doubt. So if you are into that, we will see you again. We'll probably do another quiz on Sunday. Thanks for joining in. I love doing this. I love chatting to you. I love, you know, the fact that you guys can chat and have fun in the side chat and people enjoy it. It's fantastic. So thanks for joining in. Well done to Alan. Hopefully I'll bump into you again soon at the boot sale, Alan. And he's put there. Cheers, Nick. Have a good evening all. Thank you. Right. Take care. I'm off. See you later. How many points did I get again? Did I get, says Kelly, none. Yeah, you got none, Kelly. Not quick enough. You need to work on those typing skills. All right, take care, guys.